First order of business is public comment on non-agenda items. Does anybody have any comments they'd like to make? Suzanne?
Hi, it's come to my attention that you all are using Roundup around the irrigation ponds. Something to do.
By you all, do you mean anybody in particular or this?
No, that's the big y'all. And I'm wondering if there's another way that we could deal with whatever the issue is by mowing instead of spraying something that's, I think, fairly toxic. I know it's controversial, but if there's another way we can handle the killing of weeds around ponds.
I don't know, but I don't have any trouble trying to find out.
There are other chemicals that are supposedly organic and less harmful.
Less toxic.
Commercially available, I'm sure there are.
Just who does that question?
I'm sure we can find.
And it's part of our permits with DEP for the spray lagoons is that they don't want plants growing up on the inside of the lagoons.
Inside of the what?
On the inside of the lagoons.
We can't hear either.
I said it's part of the permits with DEP for the spray lagoons.
Jim, do you think they could be mowed?
No, it's not possible. They're too steep. And they're also usually lined with riprap. If you're not familiar with riprap, it's large stones. The only thing I've ever heard of doing is attempting to pull them by hand. But we'll take a look and see if there's other things that can be done.
Okay, I'll do a little investigation too.
Okay, I think Richard was next. You had your hand up, Richard.
I was going to ask for the public address to be turned on or be used or something, but also I'd like to say how good the chemical cultivation seems to work, and I don't see any reason to try to change it.
Okay. Sue, go on.
You know, we had a discussion about using Roundup before on the Township Park, and I think, you know, for sure it's worthwhile looking into organic, but I do want to caution you to take a look at the organic, because just because it's organic doesn't mean it's non-toxic. And so I think that is an important part of the issue as well.
Okay. This is Pamantha.
Yes, I want to thank you for the horrible road. It really is nice, but it's so dangerous. I'd like a sign saying Black Horse Bypass. I also would like to let you people know that I don't know what's going to happen to my house. I haven't found any cracks yet, but it vibrated so well that I thought we were having an earthquake for 2 days. I actually left the second day because I couldn't stand it. I also have a well in front of my house. How do I know that all of this hasn't been created by you people? If I have a problem in the next few months.
If you have a problem, let us know about it.
And what are you going to do about it? The same thing you did with the road.
Well, I'm not going to do anything about it because I'm not going to be here after the first year.
Well, the rest of you didn't do anything, and you didn't warn us that my whole house was going to vibrate. The pictures on the walls were dancing.
Okay. We finished? Kit,
yeah, but
have your hand up.
Yeah, and if this is better at a different spot, that's fine, but I was just wondering, I don't see it on the agenda. I wanted to know how it was going with the sewer plant, please. Talked about it a couple of meetings ago.
Is that on the agenda?
I don't think so.
No, it's not. No.
Okay, Steve, where are we on that?
We sent out, actually, to the board today, modified RFQ documents and bid documents for their final look. Mm-hmm. And subject to that, I think we're ready to move forward with that process.
So you call it an RFQ?
Yes, because it's a license agreement, it's not a sale.
Uh-huh.
So it's not an RFP, it's an RFQ, which is a request for qualifications for qualified bidders who would then operate.
Okay, so that hasn't even been let out yet?
No.
Uh-huh, okay.
Okay. Okay. Suzanne, how'd your hand help you?
Yes, I wanted to thank Sue for her comment, because I totally agree. And from what I understand, there are methods of mowing that would negate having to use anything on those fields, except perhaps by spot welding around the little areas where you have to hand pluck. And I understand that's an issue somewhere where the baselines are or something.
You're talking about the spray
fields? No, now I'm going back to the, we were talking, we brought that up with the baseball fields, about putting Roundup on the baseball fields, et cetera. And I know there are methods of just mowing that would negate using anything. And I'm happy to look again for that information. I haven't seen it in a while, but I know that there are communities that have used it and have never had to do anything, fertilize or anything again, once they started using these mowing methods. I'll look it up for you.
Okay, someone over here, other hand up. Brian, I think, then.
Okay, this was fairly old, that Jim had mentioned that there were some proposals that he had gathered that were supposed to go to the board to looking about evaluating the township space requirements and make recommendations. Has the board done anything with that? Have you guys moved forward, if we're going to have somebody look at it, or is it still hanging fire?
We haven't, to my knowledge, done anything with it. You'll hear about it first. It'll have to happen in a forum like this, I believe.
Okay. And I've got to go and rephrase that, because it's... No, I'm going to do it this... Yes. I thought about doing this at the bill section, but I'd probably get hollered at because it wasn't financial related. Back on the 14th or the 28th of September Board of Supervisors meeting, I asked about the Route 401 sidewalk paving spec. Jim reviewed it later on, and he claimed that I was confused, that the sidewalk spec, or I confused the sidewalk spec with the horseshoe trail spec. And then I said I had not, and that literally the sidewalk specification said that the contractor was to complete the following: installation of cold-in-place recycled paving and hot wearing course. And I asked the question, how are you going to do this when where the sidewalk is, you've got trees, dirt, and rocks? Jim Gwen said, no, you're confused between the two. I went back and I pulled the pen bid specification for the Route 401 sidewalk, and I had a copy of the horseshoe trail specification, but I left it in the zip file that the sidewalk spec came in. And the sidewalk spec, fresh from pen bid, said that it's supposed to be done with installation of cold in place recycled paving and hot wearing course. Now, I sent that information to you guys, to the Board of Supervisors, and to Jim. Jim, is it still your position that I was confused and the specification did not include that?
Brian, I don't know what you sent me or didn't send me. I didn't see anything recently from you. All I can tell you is that the work is done, and that Carroll Engineering has certified to us that the work was done in accordance with the specifications.
I sent this to you back on the early September, late August.
Brian, I get so many emails, I do not remember you sending me anything at all with respect to that.
Then I'll go and ask you about my next one. And this was back at the 20th of September Board of Supervisors meeting. I asked you about the OSHA reports concerning D&L construction that I had sent to you at all the Board of Supervisors meeting, because earlier on at a prior meeting, you had said that OSHA had inspected D&L construction and found no problems with them. I said I had done a Freedom of Information Act, and yes, they had been inspected, but they had been cited, they had been fined, and they hadn't paid it. And not only that, but the OSHA's opinion was that people working there were employees and not independent contractors. When I first brought it up, you said, I just got that today, I haven't looked at it, etc. We've had some time since then. Have you looked at it since then? Do you still take the position
that OSHA found nothing wrong with DNL's work?
I do not.
You do not what?
Brian, do you have a point you're trying to make here?
Yes, I do.
Could you get to your point, please?
I want to know whether Jim still holds to his position that OSHA inspected DNL Construction, found that their people were independent contractors, there was no problems with the work, and with everything was peachy neat and fine.
And I said, I do not.
Is that all, Brian?
I'm still not quite understanding it, but okay.
Yeah, that's not the answer to the question.
Okay, Sarah, had your hand up?
Oh, yes, thank you for reminding me. I got lost over there. Is there an update on the Fellowship Trail project? Has there was going to be a bid package prepared?
Carol Engineering is preparing the bid package, and I spoke with Chairman Miller, who reminded me of that earlier today. I'm in the process of getting a hold of Carol Engineering to find out where it is. So as soon as I have it, obviously the board will also have it.
Thank you. We've been working on that for, 4 years or something now. It would be great to have it moving forward, so thank you.
Okay. Other comments? Jane.
You said that Carol Engineering looked at the sidewalk and approved that it was done in accordance to the plans. Has Black Horse Road been looked at and the same happened there?
The engineer did look at Black Horse Road. He is in the process of working with his inspector to find out exactly certain things that happened out there. The problem is our township representative was on sick leave for a while, so he's back, and he has been out of the site. He has looked at things. He and I spoke several times over the last few weeks, including last Friday, and as of last Friday, he was in the process of working with his inspector to figure out exactly, to come fully up to speed as to what had happened out there. So I'm waiting to hear back from him.
So how do they go about approving something per the plan that was never on the plan?
And that's something I'll have to get back to you on, because I've asked that from Ken Yerger.
I still want to know their version of a swell and a ditch.
I can't help you out, Ms. Monta.
Well, ain't no damn swell there. It's a ditch.
Brian?
I've got a question. How do they inspect work that was never shown on the plan that it was done properly?
When the work was done out there, the engineer laid out every elevation and approved every change and every material application that we did. He was there the entire time we're paving, checking on the weight slips, the temperature, and the process to put the blacktop down.
Okay, that's fine with the blacktop.
He checked the elevation for every pipe. He checked the elevation for the bottoms of the swales, the shoulders of the swales, the pipe that goes under the road, the specifications for the driveway improvements to match the new paving.
Okay.
I was there at least twice, mostly three times every day.
Okay. So there's records then of what he was inspecting and what was
yes.
done? Okay.
Yep.
Now, how about the where it was past where the plan is, between the end of the plan and Upper Euclid?
What?
Who inspected that work?
Carol Engineering, the same guy.
What did they inspect it to?
They gave us specs before we started that portion, and they inspected to make sure we met their requirements.
So you have written specifications from them for that work beyond the plan that you showed the residents earlier on?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. That plan is available, I assume, correct?
I imagine.
I'm going to say it a different way. I don't want your imagination. I need an answer.
Oh, my goodness.
Sorry, Brian.
Brian, you need to be at least decent to our public officials while you're sitting in this room, I believe.
Here.
Thank you.
Brian,
hold on.
Fine, I'm going to shut up.
Hey, David.
Maybe it's up, but I hadn't seen it. Are we gonna put the speed signs back up?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep. Francis?
I remember residents asking if they would be able to mow up to the new road so it wouldn't be overgrown. Is that, I haven't been on Blackhorse Road, but will they be able to mow right up to the road?
Yeah. They trimmed with weed eaters before. Nobody mowed with a lawnmower hardly at all to the edge of the road, edge of the pavement. Jane?
I think you're wrong about that. So I just heard a gasp out of Sophie and myself as well. I mowed right out to the road because up until recently, I had an electric weed eater. So I didn't have enough cord to reach down to the road.
Okay, I stand corrected.
And my other point is, as far as the drains that were put in, if they were done to engineering spec, I find that very hard to believe, since there is no depression that goes down into the drain. I don't even know how the water's gonna get to those drains because they're up higher than anything else.
They were done to engineer specs.
But we're better off with the old one that was there.
Okay, is there any other comments? Okay, the next item on the agenda is to approve the minutes of the November 9th meeting. Do you hear a motion to approve?
So moved. Second.
Any comments? All those in favor?
Aye.
Jim, manager's report.
Thank you. Just a couple of things I'd like to note. Township offices will be closed this coming Thursday and Friday in observance of the Thanksgiving holiday. The turkey trot will be held in Township Park and on nearby roads on Friday, the 27th. I believe this is also further on the agenda, so we'll give more detail then. The monthly EAC meeting is scheduled for Wednesday, December 2nd at 5:30 p.m. The monthly Park and Recreation Commission meeting is scheduled for Wednesday, December 2nd at 7:30 p.m. To the extent an executive session is held, the next executive session is scheduled for Monday, December 7th at 7:30 p.m. The combined November-December meeting of Regional Planning Group is scheduled for Thursday, December 10th at 7:30 p.m. at Schuylkill Township Building. And the next scheduled meeting of the Board of Supervisors is Monday, December 14th at 7:30 p.m.
Treasurer's report, Jim.
Treasurer's report, this is for the month ended October 31st, 2015. Revenues, earned income tax, $40,870.53. Real estate taxes, $9,370.40. Transfer taxes, $15,686.20. Open city space taxes of $20,672.12. Other $258,296.35 for a total of $344,895.60. Bills paid, bills list of 1012, $231,142.39. 1026, $95,739.73 for a total of, looks like, yeah, that total is wrong, so I'll leave that total out. Payroll total, $97,311.08. What this says is that the there is a payment due December 1st on the 2012 bond issue, which will be open space interest and principal. That payment was approved on the last bills list, which was in November. General fund balances as to the end of the month were, general fund was $1,374,922.74. Open space taxes of $2,040,760.13. And liquid fuel funds of $8,891.62.
Joe, I have one question. The other, the large item, other revenues?
Yes.
$758,000, what was it?
That's a combination of things. That would be fees paid, building permit fees, other receipts by the township, could include quarterly payments by Comcast and Verizon for
franchise
fees, I'm sorry, and things of that nature. So it's usually a variety of other receipts.
Thank you. Okay, Mike, please report.
Okay, during the month of October, the police department responded to 155 calls for service, including the arrest of a 44-year-old male for vandalism of an unoccupied vehicle parked at Stone Rise apartment complex, and the arrest of a 26-year-old male for unlawful use of computer and related charges in the 900 block of Pottstown Pike.
Okay, the active subdivision report is next. Shows no applications, the action from the board tonight. The bills list for November 23rd, 2015, general fund bills list is $113,378.71. The reimbursable bills list is $8,644.59. The subdivision utility plant bills list is $2,498.67 for a total bills list of $124,521.97.
Move the approval of the bills list.
Second. Any comment? Brian?
We've got an entry there for birds for our materials, some 2B stone. What do we use that for?
We use it to backfill pipe and wherever we need clean stone to make any kind of drainage structure of any kind. We always try to keep some in stock.
That's a general term of what it's used for, but what was this particular order used for?
For stock. I just said we always keep some in stock.
Okay, so what have we been doing any work to where we've used this besides Black Horse Road?
I have to go back and look at it.
We've got something for Chester County SPCA for $300. Will this be obviated by the multi-year agreement later on in the meeting?
No.
Okay.
This relates to the agreement that's in place, not to a future agreement.
I said, will it be necessary in the future? Is it different fees or is it different things we're being paid for? Because I don't know what's in the agreement either.
The answer is that we will still be subject to those type of fees in the future.
Okay. H-A-Y-G-A-M. Is this for the white lawns that are along the ditches on Black Horse Road?
Partly that, and also to replace some signs, road signs.
Okay. This KDH Defense Systems, and it says Park Patrol Reimbursement Department of Justice. Speaking to the chief before the meeting, he said it was actually paid for by a donation to someone. Shouldn't that be in reimbursable as opposed to township bill then?
I'd have to ask the treasurer. I'm not sure how she does that.
Okay. Pavement group. It says it's a partial payment for about close to $36,000. How many partial payments do we have to them? And why are they broken up?
This was, this is either 75 or 85% of the total bill. If you recall, the their bid was just under $50,000. So the contract, which Carroll Engineering certified that the work was done in accordance with the contract, provides for them to obtain a certain percentage of it upon substantial completion, and then the balance upon final completion. And so what they've done is that they've submitted for what's allowed for under the contract, which is the $35,996.92, and the balance will be billed at some later date to take it up to just under $50,000.
Okay. Under reimbursable bills, we've got one from John Eldridge, fabricated sign post. Do we have beautiful signs for beautiful birth front bill now, or are they still in a real soon now mode?
Harry, I believe the answer to that.
Those are still in the real soon mode. John has them at his home, he's putting the, he's filling something in with posts, and it's about to rip.
Okay. We've got one for, it says NJ, okay, I'm assuming it's New Jersey Easy Path Processing Center. For $80, it's reimbursable. Why do we have a reimbursable for Easy Pass?
We have a reimbursable for Easy Pass because a contractor took the truck over to New Jersey and didn't pay the tolls. So the township was sent a notice from Easy Pass that the tag is our tag on the truck. So we were assessed the toll and also an administrative fee, and we've gone back to the contractor whose worker did this, and they've agreed to reimburse us for the administrative fee.
So we have contractors operating township equipment?
No, this is a contractor who took the truck over to New Jersey for some work that had to be done to it. So they're not operating the equipment as a piece of equipment. They're merely transporting the equipment on our behalf.
Okay, but we had a contractor do this rather than our own people.
That's correct.
Okay. Looking at Black Horse Road, we've got, Cedar Hollow for $2,670.09. Highway Materials for $36,227.09. Sweetwater Natural Products for $90. Walt's Turf Farm for $284. And so that this bills list, it comes to $39,272.01. So my calculation from what the bills list shows for what we're paying to contractors is $164,818, and it comes to 26 cents by my listing. That puts us at 119% over the value that was supposed to be, or we were told was going to be, of $75,000, and that's only so far, because I haven't seen any bills for concrete inlets, so I guess we still have those coming in. We're still even 9.8% over the done by others value that we were supposed to be saving money on. And these costs don't include the road crew's time with their wages and benefits. Do we have any idea how many hours that the road crew has spent on this?
I haven't had a chance to go over the time card yet, so I can't give you a final figure.
I'm not asking for a final figure. Do we have a figure right now?
I don't have a figure except for a final figure, and I don't have it yet.
Okay. Is there somebody that was monitoring these costs as the job was going forward, that someone functions as a project manager?
I guess that would be me. Okay. Why are you glaring at me, Brian? Just say yes or no, you hate me or not.
I'm not glaring at you. I'm just asking a question. You know, and I'm thinking, do I want to go and ask the question, how did we go and get so far over there? But I probably wouldn't get a good answer. So
I got to check the numbers, Brian. And I'll add them all up and have them for the next meeting.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, Jane.
How did we get to this point? Because I had in my notes from, I think it was October 12th, when we talked about the first contract being voided, and you awarded the next contract to D&L Paving and Excavating for the grade work. I have here that the bid was at $10,275, and the paving bid was $10,845. That was supposed to finish the project. So how are we now at, I think Brian said 100, was it 164 something, Brian?
As I told Brian, I have to add everything up, Jane, and I'll let you know. Any other questions? Motion's been made to approve the bills list. Seconded, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Request to use the meeting room for the Stonecross HOA on December 9th from 6 to 8:30 p.m.
Seems okay. I'm going to be approved.
Second. Any comment? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Request from Beverly Lawler, the branch manager of the Henrietta Hankin Library, for their yearly contribution. How much is that contribution, Jim?
$500.
$500, I think it's $500.
$500, huh?
We've been doing this for years, at least the last two.
Actually, no, we originally were contributing matching funds because the library at Yellow Springs had a grant, and as part of the grant, they required some matching funds, so in years ago, it was actually for the Yellow Springs Library. Then once the library came to West Vincent, it was moved over to West Vincent.
But I know we contributed last year, maybe the year before.
I think that's correct, yes.
So then I'll make a motion that we approve the donation of $500 to the library.
I'm going to abstain on this because I sit on the board of the Friends of the Hankin Library.
Okay, I'll second that. Is there any comment? All those in favor?
Aye.
We have a request from the Delaware Valley Health Insurance Trust for Alsace Township, Berks County, to join and to vote for a board treasurer. Jim, you want to go over that?
Yes, one person is running for a board treasurer, and that would be Don Berger, who's the manager of Springfield Township, Montgomery County. And pursuant to the bylaws of the Delaware Valley Health Trust, every existing member gets to vote on any new member which wishes to join. Alsace Township, which is in Berks County, would like to join. They have a total of 5 employees who would be covered by the DIVET medical line.
Just in general, adding more townships can only strengthen this organization.
That is correct, yes.
So what action do we need to take?
A motion to allow me to vote on behalf of Don Berger as the candidate for treasurer, and also to vote to add Alsace Township, Berks County, as a full member of the trust.
They have a separate motion, but one motion to do it.
I think one motion should do it.
I so moved.
Second. Any comment? All those in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Request from Tammy Slavy to attend an administrative seminar on January 27th, 2016.
What's that about,
Tammy? I'm sorry?
What was that about? Just
it's in your book. It's a general how to deal with people type.
This is, I'm sorry,
$149, is that right?
That was the question I was going to ask.
That's it.
Okay, we'll hear a motion.
You do.
So,
second.
Any comments? All those in favor?
Aye.
We need to consider acceptance of resignation from Ray Lisvinsky from the Township Police Department. Hear a motion?
Move we accept the resignation.
Second. Any comment?
Yeah, we need that to also authorize. And can his chairman execute any documents related to the resignation?
I accept the amendment.
Second that amendment?
Please.
Second that amendment.
Any comment? Brian?
We'll be hiring a replacement officer, correct?
Probably.
Okay.
Any other comments? Maria?
Is he full-time or part-time?
He's full-time.
Thank you.
Any other comments? Motion been made and seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Okay, as a notice, the turkey trot, the annual turkey trot, is on November 27th. Registration is at 9 a.m. with the race starting at 10 a.m. at the Township Park. There's subdivision, excuse me, land development, Toll Brothers, Eagle Farms, escrow release from bond number SU1127841 for phase 2A Sprayfield. Jim?
Yeah, this is, this I believe has already been approved by Upper Euclid Township, which you'll notice in your packet. What you need to do is move this on to Carroll Engineering for its review to determine whether or not this is acceptable so that the security can be released.
So And we need a motion to send this on to Carol for their approval?
Correct. And then what will happen is once they have made a recommendation, we'll come back to you for your approval.
And I'll make that recommendation, and should we mention the total amount that they're asking for?
Sure.
The total amount that they're asking for is $122,266.60.
Second.
Any comments?
Brian?
Is this a spray field that's inside of West Vincent, or is it inside of Upper Euclid that services the residents of Eagle Farms that are inside of West Vincent?
This is inside West Vincent. It services only residents of West Vincent.
So there's a sewage plant that is associated with Eagle Farms that's inside of West Vincent that services those there?
No. There is a treatment plant that is in Upper Euclid. There is an intermunicipal agreement between the developers, West Vincent Township and Upper Euclid Township. The treatment is done in Upper Euclid, and then the flow that comes in from West Vincent is sent back for disposal on spray fields that are in West Vincent.
So there's some spray fields over in the Eagle Farms development that are in West Vincent that gets the flow toward the fluids from West Vincent after it's been treated inside of Upper Euclid?
That's correct.
Okay, thank you.
Any other comments? Maria?
I think that when I was reading the budget summary, said that we had like $200,000 in escrow, and if you're taking $100,000 out, is that $200,000 still it? Is that completely different from this? Is that already considered out?
This is irrespective. This is not an escrow. This is a separate bond that has been posted by the developer, and what actually the developer is asking for is that the security, which is the bond, be reduced. So it has nothing to do with the amounts in escrow which are being held by West Vincent.
All right, thank you.
Other comments? Those in favor?
Aye.
All right. Under old business, we need to consider authorizing the 2016 budget for public review and advertisement. Do you have a motion for the same?
So moved.
Second.
Any comment? Those in favor?
Aye.
Under new business, we have resolution number 17 of 2015, the acceptance of land from the County of Chester, tax parcels 25401E, 25421E, 25422E, which total to approximately 56 acres along French Creek between Cheater Mill Road and the Township line, I guess. Is that right? No, that wouldn't be right.
No, it goes actually past Cook's Glen Road and along
the Camp Sankin that follows, right?
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
It's all in West Vincent.
Yes, this is all in West Vincent. It's all on the south side of French Creek.
This has been a long time coming. Did we?
I'm told that it's about 30 years that this has been in the works. This is county parkland that is, for the most part, heavily wooded. It's also a floodplain. It also has the French Creek, which goes through it. There is a small field that is cut by one of the residents of the township. But it's essentially undeveloped land. There is some horse trails through it. And it is, I believe, most of it is in fly fishing area along French Creek. Because I know Dame Juliana has done some work along the banks of these parcels.
So if we do this, are we going to turn it over to Parks and Recs to figure out what, if any, to do with it?
I think that makes sense. As it sits right now, it's essentially undeveloped, and maybe the best use for it continues to be as something that's undeveloped. I think this is probably land which may be acceptable as part of the archery program that the township has for deer management. But again, that's a possibility. There's a number of different possibilities, but there's no nothing set as at this time. It's just that this was previously before this board, I think, on several occasions, and the county saw fit not to take action. We're told that the county has reversed its position and will take action by the end of the year. Hopefully that'll happen.
Is there anything, any negative possibilities in our taking?
Just that we're going to have to insure it, but as essentially the land without improvements, it shouldn't be much of an insurance burden.
So what do we need? Do we need to move to accept this?
Yes.
I will so move.
Second. Do we need to read it at all?
You should read the resolution at the bottom of it out there. You can read it and caption it.
Is it my turn, David? Now therefore be it resolved, and it is hereby resolved by the Board of Supervisors of West Vincent Township, that the township accepts the dedication and conveyance of the subject property from Chester County, a third-class county, in fee simple to the township, for and in consideration of the sum of $1, subject to the condition of title and the form of documentation conveying title being acceptable to the Township Board of Supervisors and its consultants. The township supervisors, manager, staff, solicitor, and representative shall have the due authority to take any and all actions in order to effectuate said conveyance.
Okay, do I hear a motion to pass resolution 17 of 2015 as read?
So moved.
Second.
Any comment? Brian?
I'm looking at a resolution that was passed back in 2011. And the verbiage is very similar to what John just gave without being able to go and look at both of them, like, you know, side by side. Is there some reason why we need to do it again after we did it back in 2011?
Steve, do you have anything?
Ken asked me the same question prior to coming in here this evening. Did we already do this? And I said, I don't recall specifically. It's been out there for 25 years or so. I think we were poised to do it at that point in time, but the county was not, and there was a hiccup in the process, and they had changed their mind. So my view is we do need to do it at this point in time because all the documentation's now lined up, and they've indicated a willingness to go forward. And I think we need to have a contemporaneous resolution that says we're willing to go forward.
Okay, and it'll be interesting to see whether they actually go forward. Because the meeting minutes, the way they read, it sounded like they were ready to go forward back then, too. Okay, thank you.
Sharon. Okay, Sharon.
Pam Brown was very involved with this thing for 30 years. It is a lovely, beautiful, beautiful piece of trail along there and woods and stream. One of the problems was, my understanding is that back then, Costello wanted the township to pay money for it, and the township said, no, we're not going to, and that's when it fell apart. That's my understanding of what happened. So the dollar's a great deal, guys. Thank you very much.
Yeah, and I think the other thing that happened at that time is that the Parks Department was disbanded by the county.
That's right.
And was made part of the Maintenance Department, so that all the people who were involved with this potential transfer were either let go or reassigned to the Maintenance Department. So that was another reason why this didn't move forward.
Okay. Brian?
One other little point of information. There apparently is a county trail that runs through at least part of it. I remember going up, not Black Horse, but Sawmill Road, and coming from French Creek, it's on the left-hand side. There's a placard and some signage, et cetera. Where it goes back to inside of the property, I don't know. But it does look like there is at least some trail that goes in there somewhere.
I think that's the French Creek Trail Run. As you cross into West Vincent, it's on your left.
That's as you cross into West Vincent, you bend around past Cook Glen, yeah. And that's, then it goes off on the left.
That's part of the French Creek Trail.
Okay. As I said, I think all I know of is it was, I saw a trail sign, I didn't take the trail.
George.
If Other than insurance, there's no cost associated with this, well, counting the maintenance, the partner's getting rid of it, I'm just wondering why. Is there maintenance costs associated with it, or is this?
I can't imagine much. Someone who's cutting the lawn or the field now?
It's Woodland.
It's Woodland, it's my understanding that the issue is the county is that they have people at Warwick Park, and they don't have personnel to police it.
But there is a field that we may want to, kind of, 2 or 3 acre field, it looks like, off the top of my head.
Right.
That would be it.
Okay, George? Sarah?
My recollection from 5 or 6 years ago is that the county, it was not the size and shape of the parcel that the county wanted to take management responsibility for. They've really been trying to turn it over to us for a long time with lots of hiccups. But it was not the kind of thing that, size and shape and location was not suitable for, it didn't fit in the county's park plan. And so having it belong to the township, they had determined long ago was the right place for it. They just got caught up in the mechanism of how to make it happen. So the Parks and Rec Committee is looking forward to taking a look at it and making recommendations.
Okay, any other comments? Okay, motions been made and seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
We need to authorize advertisement of the appointment of an outside auditor. Somebody want to make a motion?
I move the township authorize the advertisement of a notice of the township intent to appoint Bob King Thornton as the appointed township auditor and considered at the board's organization meeting on January 4th, 2016.
Right, second that motion.
Any comment? All those in favor?
Aye.
Need a motion to authorize the advertisement of the reorganization meeting on January 4th, 2016.
I move the township authorize the advertisement of the notice of the organization meeting to be held by the Township Board of Supervisors on January 4th, 2016 at 7:30 p.m.
Second.
Any comment? All those in favor?
Aye.
I need to authorize advertisement of the township auditor meeting on January 5th, 2016.
Your turn.
Oh, come on. I move that the township authorize the advertisement of a notice of the township auditor's meeting to be held on January 5th, 2016 at 5 p.m.
Second.
Any comment? All those in favor?
Aye.
We have a stormwater agreement to consider for 60 Lily Pond Lane. Dave, you want to? There's a synopsis of this. Well, Jim, I'm
going to try it.
Again, this is a stormwater management agreement that's required by our stormwater ordinance, which is in compliance with the county's ordinance. With respect to that, this is a situation where this is 60 Lily Pond Lane. I believe this is for a construction of a pool with pool decking and fence. It was been reviewed by Carroll Engineering, and the determination by Carroll Engineering was that the best management practice easement is shown and that it's in compliance with our stormwater management ordinance.
So then what action do we take?
We take an action to approve the stormwater best management practices and conveyance operation and maintenance agreement with Eric and Tanya Karras.
So moved. Second.
Any comment? Those in favor?
Aye.
I have a stormwater agreement to consider approval of for 2742 Horseshoe Trail.
And this is for a construction of a proposed woodworking garage shop and new loop driveway segment with an infiltration trench BMP. Earth disturbance is approximately 5,000 square feet, so it's subject to the ordinance. Carroll Engineering has determined that this is in compliance with our stormwater ordinance and recommends that the
I'm really sorry about this, but I can't take it
in. and recommends that the board approve the simplified approach stormwater best management practices, operation, maintenance, and inspection plan in the agreement.
And the other thing that Carol recommended is taken care of?
Yes.
Then I'll make the motion that we approve this request.
Second. Any comment? All those in favor?
Aye.
We have a stormwater agreement for 18 Pine Drive.
This is for a new lot. This is to construct a new residential dwelling, driveway, on-lot sanitary system, and seepage bed to control the new impervious coverage. This is a lot that was conveyed, I believe, by Mr. Bellotti. And the new owner proposes to build a dwelling driveway and septic on it. And Carol Engineering has reviewed that and has recommended that this board approve a stormwater best management practices and conveyance operation and maintenance agreement.
Your motion to approve?
So moved.
Second. Any comments?
And this also has to echo John's comments on the last one. Conditions of Carol's approval have been met.
That's correct. Those in favor, seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Chester County SPCA multi-year agreement.
Chester County, we have currently have a year-to-year agreement with Chester County SPCA, which provides for certain services for stray dogs and cats. What they've proposed to all municipalities is that there be a three-year agreement for full participants, it starts at $1,500, and that there will be a 3% increase every year. So in 2016, 17, and 18, there will be 3% increases. And they've also added an emergency fee of $100 for services rendered outside normal business hours.
And the primary difference in this, the $1,000 plan and the $1,500, is if you have two occurrences, you're going to spend that extra $500 in a hurry.
That's correct.
And we were way over that this year, correct?
That's correct.
So the $1,500 looks like the plan.
Okay. Want to make a motion about it, John?
Sure. Make a motion that we go for the $1,500 a year plan for the Chester County SPCA Animal Protection Services.
Second. Any comments? All those in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Item 22, David, you have to do that.
This item 22 deals with certain farmland. And Ken can't participate in this except to break a tie because the farmland is leased to him. This is land, 43 tillable acres of real property situated in West Vincent, known as the Clyde Griffith property. The existing lease is dated 24 April 2006. Has been renewed, so I assume this is a for a new lease or for extension of the present one?
It's for extension of the present lease, okay, for another term.
Okay. I would move that this lease be extended for the term of what budget?
It's for 5 years.
5 years. That's my motion.
At the same rate?
I assume so.
If I could comment, whatever. I know that you changed the terms for St. Gas, which would be okay with me, that same type of thing. But
yeah, I think we got, Jim, correct me if I'm wrong, the last lease went to $55.
That's correct.
I'm not trying to make it unreasonable to cut. Does that make sense to you?
Yeah, I think it has
a
it goes up every year, is that right?
Yeah, no, I don't think it does.
Okay.
So what I would amend your motion just to take it from 52 to 55 for right now.
I accept the amendment. Oh, I guess I'm presiding. Any comment? Fine.
This is, that $55 value, is that the same as what it was on the, I'm going to say the southwest corner there of Horseshoe Trail and Route 100? I'm going to say kind of opposite where this is, I think.
That's the guest property.
That's correct.
Yeah.
Okay.
My understanding is the same.
Yeah. Thank you.
Other comment? Maria.
What are the terms of things? I remember looking at this lease about 4 years ago, and I know I had some questions with the way it was written in the beginning and the end of it. So it has 5-year renewable terms. How many 5-year renewable terms are in the current lease?
There's no limit on a number of 5-year terms. It just, it can be terminated. Wait a minute, I should say that. It can be renewed upon written agreement. It takes a written agreement between both parties on December 31st before the end.
So it can go on indefinitely?
No.
No.
It has
well,
to
5 years in renewable terms.
5 years.
It doesn't renew automatically, Maria. It's got to be.
Well, last time they said that it did. That's why I'm asking.
But it doesn't this time. It says that it has to be a written agreement.
Okay. Because the last time we had failed to do the written agreement. And, you know, I was told then that it did just automatically renew, so I'm confused with the terms of that lease. You know, and I'm going off of memory from that, but that was my question, you know, 4 years ago.
I can't go back 5 years and answer that, but I'm telling you, but it's in front of you.
Yeah, the operative term is the term of this lease shall be from the date of this lease agreement, and shall end December 31st, 2010, the initial term. After the initial term, the term can be renewed for an additional 5-year period upon written agreement of the township and tenant prior to the termination of the lease agreement. So, somebody's there.
I just thought that originally the wording was a little nebulous, and I just thought that maybe we should shore it up to say, if it's not done in writing, it ends. And that was what didn't happen the last time. So I just thought that the terminology seemed a little loose. My other question is, I'm sorry, I forgot what it was.
Okay. Any further discussion? Do you have your hand up on it?
Yeah. And I'm going from memory here. At one of the recent sustainability meetings, they mentioned, and I don't know whether this was in the sustainability plan or not, that township farmlands that are leased should only be farmed organically and using non-GMO modified crops, etc. Is there anything in this agreement to that effect?
Not that I've seen. And what the sustainability committee does not bind this board.
Well, your sustainability plan is a part of your zoning ordinance.
No part of it is mandatory, Brian. It's all goals.
It's all goals. There's no requirements.
Well, there may be one or two mandatory things. I don't want to mistake. But almost all of it is goals.
Okay. But then it's a goal that we don't want to work towards, achieve, or something like that?
It doesn't bind us. As a board. Maria?
Okay. I remember now. Thank you. Is the payment of the lease paid in arrears or upfront?
Payment is paid by the end of the year.
But is it the end of the year, so it's in arrears? It's for the year that had just passed?
That's correct. Which is typical for farming leases because they don't get the crops until the end of the year, so they don't have the money to pay for it until the end of the year.
Okay. No problem. I just wanted to know.
Right.
Somebody said that, Sarah.
My recollection about the sustainability goal is to use no-till farming. It was not specifying organic or otherwise, but it's not yet incorporated into our zoning ordinance. Anyway, it's one of the recommendations from the sustainability committee. Okay.
Further discussion? Seeing none, call for a vote. All those in favor?
Aye.
Motion passes.
Okay, I'll hear a motion to adjourn.
Second.
Before we adjourn, we are going to be in executive session after this meeting. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.